हेलो स्टूडेंट, सो लेट सी दी वर्टिब्रल कॉलम. सो वर्टिब्रल कॉलम, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड दी स्पाइन, स्पाइनल बोन, और दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड दी बैक बोन. सो इट फॉर्मिंग दी सेंट्रल एक्सिस ऑफ द बॉडी एंड इट सपोर्ट द बॉडी एंड ट्रांसमिट्स दी बॉडी वेट इन टू दी ग्राउंड थ्रू आउट दी लोअर लिम. दी यू नो दी वर्टिब्रल कॉलम दैट शुड बी मेड बाय दी 33 वर्टिब्रा, दैट इज दी 7 सर्वाइकल, 12 थोरेसिक, 5 लंबर, 5 सैक्रल एंड दी 4 आर दी कॉक्सिजियल. सो लेट सी दी डिटेल्स ऑफ दी वर्टिब्रा एंड दी वर्टिब्रल कॉलम. सो हियर इन दिस डायग्राम यू कैन सी दैट इज दी वर्टिब्रल कॉलम. हियर दैट इज दी रेड कलर सर्वाइकल 7 वर्टिब्रा, the blue color that is the thoracic vertebra which are 12 in numbers, then the lumbar vertebra which are 5 in numbers, the sacral green color, these are the 5 in numbers, and the coccygeal 4 vertebra they are present. So this is the posterior view of the vertebral column and this is the lateral view of the vertebral column. In the another diagram you can see this one, that is the same, this is the posterior view of the vertebral column and this is the lateral view of the vertebral column. So here you can see that is the curve of the vertebral column and that is the number of vertebra, that is the 33 vertebra, that is cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral and the coccyx. So let's see that is the details of that the vertebra. Then the spinal nerves which are arriving from that the vertebral column, these are the 31 pair of the spinal nerves and that should be comes out from the both lateral side of that the vertebra. So these 31 spinal nerves, the out of this, that is the 8 are the cervical, 12 are the thoracic, 5 are the lumbar, 5 are the sacral and 1 is the coccygeal. So in this way, that is the 31 pairs of the spinal nerve, they should be comes out from the both lateral side of that the vertebra or the vertebral column. Then that is after then let's see that is the curvature of that the vertebra. Then let's see that is the length of the vertebral column. So the length of vertebral column that is near about the 70 centimeter in the males and the 60 centimeter in the females. The intervertebral disc, it contribute near about the 1/5 of the length of the vertebral column. Then the curvature of the vertebral column. So the curvature shows into that the sagittal plane and the coronal plane. So let's see first the curvature in the sagittal plane. So in the sagittal plane, that is there are the two types of curvatures are observed. That is the primary curvature and the secondary curvature. So let's see first that is the primary curvature. So the primary curvature that present at the birth due to the shape of the vertebral body. So here you can see the primary curve, that is the thoracic and the sacral region. And here both are anteriorly, that is the concave. So this one here, that is the thoracic region anteriorly concave and the sacral region that is anteriorly concave. And it goes forwards. After then, that is the secondary curvature. So this is the secondary curvature, this one, and the secondary curvature are postural and they are mainly due to the shape of the intervertebral disc. So the secondary curvature that should be occurs into that the cervical region here and into that the lumbar region. And here it shows that is the convex forward. So here cervical region, it should be convex in the forward region and into the lumbar region, it should be convex into that the forward region. So first, that is the cervical curve, it appears during the 4th to 5th month after the birth when the infant start the supporting the head. And the lumbar curve, it should be occurs during the 12 to 18 months when the child assumes the upright the posture. So that is the secondary curvature. And into the coronal plane, so there is slight lateral curve that should be occurs into that the thoracic region with the concavity towards that the left. It is possible due to that the greater use of the right upper limb and the pressure of the aorta. So that is the curvature of the spinal bone or the vertebral column. Let's see that is the part of the typical vertebra. So typical vertebra that should be made by
first that consists of the body. So body, it lies, this one that is called the body, here you can see. So it lies anteriorly and shape it is like that the cylindrical. And it is being rounded from side to side and having the flat on the upper and the lower surface, where it is joins with that the intervertebral disc. Then the pedicles. So here you can see that is the pedicles. So pedicles, they are right and the left, and they are short rounded bars which are projects backwards and somewhat that goes laterally from the posterior aspect of the body of the vertebra. So this one, that is called the pedicles. Then after them, that is the lamina. So this part, it is called the lamina. So here you can see that is the lamina. So each pedicle, that is continuous posteromedially with the vertical plane of the bone, it is called the lamina. So this one, then the lamina of the two side, it passes backwards and medially. So here you can see it passes backwards and medially to meet the midlines. So the pedicle and the lamina on both side, it constitute that is the neural arch. So this is called the neural arch. After then, the vertebral foramen. So this one, that is the vertebral foramen, it is bounded anteriorly by the posterior aspect of the body. So anteriorly, that is the vertebral foramen, it is bounded by the posterior part of the body of the vertebra. Laterally, it is bounded by, that is the pedicle, and posteromedially it is bounded by the lamina of the both side. So that is the vertebral foramen. So the vertebral foramen, it forms the short segment of the vertebral canal, and that runs through the whole length of the vertebral column, which forming or it should embed the spinal cord. Then then the spinous process or the spine of the vertebra. So as we go on the posterior side or the backward side, it is usually goes downwards. So here into that the lateral side, you can see this is the spinous process. So from the junction of the two lamina, so here that is the two lamina are present, these two lamina, they should be joined and to form that is the single spine like structure. So it is called the spinous process. Then lateral side, usually which goes somewhat downward direction. So this one, at the junction of the lamina and the pedicle. So here that is the lamina and the pedicle. So from the junction, that is the two lateral parts, they should be comes from the lateral side. So that is called the transverse process. So the transverse process, it serves as the lever for the muscles and acting on the vertebral column, and same function that is done by the spinous process, that is the, it act as a lever for the muscles. Then next to it, that is the, from the junction of the pedicle and the lamina, there is present this one, that is called the superior articular process. This one, so this superior articular process, it projects the upwards and slightly on the medial side. Then the, on the inferior side, there is presence the inferior articular process. So each process bears a smooth articular facet. So that is the superior facet of the one vertebra, it articulates with the inferior facet of the above vertebra. Then the pedicle, it is much narrower into that the vertical diameter than the body, and it is attached to its upper border. At the junction of the body and that is the pedicle, there is shows that is the small depressed part, it is called the superior vertebral notch. And below to it, same like this, that is the deep notch is present, so that is called the inferior vertebral notch. So the superior vertebral notch, it is shallow, and the inferior vertebral notch, it is the deep. So the superior vertebral notch, it joins with the inferior vertebral notch of the upper vertebra to form the vertebral foramen, or that is called the intervertebral foramen, through which, that is the ventral and the dorsal rami of the spinal nerve, it should be comes out. So these are the parts of the typical vertebra.